your own. Hope you guys are excited for Thanksgiving. We certainly are here. We have a wonderful cornucopia of varieties of flowers this week. We have some Oncidium orchids, which are really soft and flirty. They'll be perfect on a large arrangement. Some yellow stock. Aspidistra. Some nice creamy, peachy spray roses that are really big. And then some cherry brandy roses, which are beautiful. They start red and then open yellow. And Solignum leucodendron. So we're going to start with our large arrangement. I chose a simple vase because we have kind of a lot going on. And we're going to start with our Oncidium. That's really soft and delicate, so be careful when you're using it. Can be at different heights because it's meant to look really feathery, almost like feathers. And then we're going to add some of our stock, which is nice and creamy and buttery. And the stock has a nice smell as well, which you'll love. We'll put these all off to one side of the Oncidium. It's going to pick up the yellows in the Oncidium. Then, so we don't have too many contrasting colors, we're going to add the leucodendron for some green. This leucodendron might remind you of pincushions that we had a couple weeks ago. They're in the same general family, so they work really well together, and they're really fun and almost exotic looking. We'll put these on the other side of our creamy stock. It's gonna bring some like great texture to your Thanksgiving entry point. And then we're going to take one of our Aspidistra and fold it. We can staple it as well. And just put it off to one side to push off the stalk. Now you have a nice large arrangement that's got feathery, soft, and then nice hard focal flowers. Then we'll move on to our smaller arrangement. It's good to have three arrangements around the holidays so they can go in every room that people are going to see in your house. And oh, why not the vegetable leaf first? Keep the dirty water from showing after a few days. So we'll cut our nice spray roses. And I'm going to save a couple of the laterals that don't quite fit for our bud base afterwards. And then cherry brandy roses. They'll be really beautiful when they open and they're going to pick up this yellowy, creamy texture. And then fill in the back with the same rows. So it doesn't have to be perfectly symmetrical. It's almost more fun when it's not. You can go on to your nice coffee table. And now we have our cute little spray roses for the end. And I'm going to tie these together so that they stay in the place I want them to. Okay. listening, and thank you for joining us this week. Bye!